you two planning on going to university?
I'm going to go to university, get a law degree.
We go to university and get the whole cape and the hat and everything.
I think your best chance of getting to university is as an exhibit in a jar.
Were you homeschooled?
No, but like.
Well, I'm trying to get to the root of the problem.
You have like loads of siblings, and then they like want to be famous as well.
There's more?
Yeah, we have more. Like,
who am I?
Peter.
Oh. Okay, ask me.
Who am I?
Peter.
Yeah. Jeez, right. You guys.
Ask me.
Who am I?
Jordan's ex-husband.
Comedian who's been on kids TV, sings in a choir, and looks like that. The fact he's not a child molester once lost me £100. It's Miles Jupp. As a member of Destiny's Child, she's one of the most famous and beautiful women in the world's friend. Please welcome Michelle Williams.
Sign up for.
That's as harsh as it gets.
That's as bad as it gets. It'll be fine.
Can I ask you something, Carol?
No.
Did you ever see any irony in presenting a show that was aimed at old people waiting for death and calling that programme Countdown?
Danny, what do you use on your head?
Hey, sunshine, I had a perm, all right, that, 2 minutes. I used to lacquer, I used a mousse, I used a diffuser. Didn't towel dry, because that created heat and friction. No, I'd wrap now and I'd give it 20 good minutes after we did it with respect. I hope that shit falls out.
Because somebody else has.
I remember. Do you remember that girl? I forget her name that you were dating.
Yeah, yeah.
Remember the only reason you're famous, that girl.
don't be nice to me.
I will be nice.
Okay.
Jesus.
Remember, I should have booked security.
I might be excited.
I know. All right.
So have you got a mascot this evening, Lee?
I have got a mascot. Yes.
What have you got?
I brought along. This is genuinely true. I actually brought along my nan's ashes. Genuinely true. My nan was always a big fan of Countdown, and she always wanted to come on. And so this is like...
Is that
genuinely my nan's ashes.
It's not, though, is it?
It really is.
can we have a look?
Don't joke about with it, because it's genuinely real.
Oh, dear me.
Literally, it's a whole head just pushed in. When she died and we cremated her. That's it.
If she died in a fire, you would have got a discount.
You're talking about?
Okay, John, what do you get?
424.
Okay, Lee?
422.
Lee? How did you do it?
Right, you take that 422 at the top. Write that down. Don't touch it with any of the other numbers. I haven't got any faith again, you useless bitch!
I think you're going to get the conundrum because I can't press my buzzer without fingering your dead nan.
I'm not taking this seriously, but I'm just going to load my nan's dead skin dust off the monitor so I can see the conundrum. Sorry, Nan, I'm just going to move you over there.
Fingers on buzzers, it's time for today's crucial, worth 100 points.
Come on!
Countdown conundrum.
Right, can I just say, this isn't the answer, but I'm surrounded by my dry nan and you put damp on cold. I mean, what's that about? You rub it in.
You ask for when you do
get that. I like chocolate, like a kettle.
Nothing smaller than a football.
No.
Sorry to stop the recording for a sec, but can we just have a look at Diana's mic, because it's making us sound very northern. Diana, can I just ask you a question? You are, right, you're a beautiful woman, talented actress, brilliant musician. Oh, do you think God gave you that accent just to balance it all up a bit?
I know, I do!
And Jedward bejazzled you?
Yeah.
Did they pebble dash it? Or?
You bejazzled them?
Basically, a bejazzle is when you put diamonds on your lady parts. Pejazzle is when you put diamonds on your men bits.
Isn't that dangerous? Don't you worry that a magpie will steal your clitoris? I saw it happen on Autumn Watch.
It has to be Jules, so can you put hundreds of thousands?
If I dipped my testicles in glue and then dragged them along the floor of a barber's, would that be a pajazzle?
You've stolen that from an episode of Art Attack, haven't you?
I think the reason they got you into it is because the way you say it. They just thought it's quite funny every time
she
says it.
Pajazzle.
The statement I want you to argue is this. Old people shouldn't be allowed to have sex.
Brace yourselves.
A lot of people will tell you, ladies and gentlemen, that sex gets better with age. That's not technically true. You're just more grateful when it happens. Listen, there is a certain age... There's a certain age where the body's fluids stop running. Now, no, I don't want to be too graphic, but I don't know if anyone here has ever tried to eat muesli without any milk. This is a fine-looking lady, and I'm sure you've led a rich and beautiful and wonderful life. But trust me, ladies and gentlemen, you don't want to see a cock in that mouth.
Rihanna got in trouble with New York authorities when she was found to have tattooed an umbrella on her tattoo artist without a license. Wow. I think it's desperately sad when a talented singer like that becomes associated with just one song. You're beautiful. I delivered that incredibly badly, I'm sorry. I know my weaknesses. I'm a singer.
Sort of.
You get an atlas, you get your potato.
Potato.
What do you have, a potato?
You just potato.
You just take the potato while you're eating it, you have beans and everything.
Beans?
What do? Like, you have a potato, you open it up, you like, eat
is
it.
Is this show going on, or has someone just fed me LSD?
What's LSD?
What's LSD? Well, you know the people that dress you and do your hair? It's what they take.
Hair.
OK, it's what you take.
We don't take it.
They go back to their miserable lives.
Oh, cool. What are you talking about?
Shut up, dickhead.
Some really cool person, like really cool.
Yeah, he's like a cool dude. Yeah. Sure.
Yeah, he's like amazing. He's like got thick hair and he's like wears a jacket and comes down and he's like got all these people who follow him and stuff.
And
like,
he's cool.
He runs around with the planets and stuff. And sometimes
right
he flies and sometimes he sits on a boat. And other times he'll be like putting roller skates on and he'll come down the street and they'll go, I'm God, I'm here. And he'll like giving people presents and sometimes they'll get him sparklers back and he'll put like oranges in his hair and sometimes like an octopus will come down and that octopus will be like form part of his penis and they'll say, look at my octopus penis. Sometimes he'll go, fucking hell, John!
We got you!
You got me Jed Wood hair.
Sit
down.
Oh, wait,
shoot. Shoot!
You know.
Mickey, I got you something for Christmas.
Just for Emma to do.
Oh, man.
Yeah, I got you.
I've always wanted to be a wanker.
It's our panelists' job to guess the British public's top five most popular talking points. Sean. Sean, Sarah, Georgie, anything you've been... anything caught your eye in the papers?
Well, Jimmy,
this week.
We all like to put a bit of money away for a rainy day, don't we? But I think you're more prepared than Noah.
On the plus side, at least you've been in a top five list of something.
Mm.
Georgie Thompson!
And also, and then they're saying about, you know, you're going to take Gary's OB or MBE away, you know what I mean? I mean, at least he gives us pleasure with his song, You Make Us Laugh. What do they do when they rape us for our fucking tax? Nothing, they make us cry. Jimmy is funny, but 1%, fuck me.
Yeah. I think Louis' political opinions are best expressed through the medium of dance.
Yeah. Yeah, sold.
Oh, here we go.
So.
I didn't think I could feel any worse.
What a pleasure it is to be sat next to the only man in Britain more flexible than your accountant, Jimmy.
Here was your first one. Least romantic thing to do on your honeymoon. John.
Keep the receipts.
Best way to reduce stress.
Best way to reduce stress? Pay your taxes.
My half-brothers are also my cousins, which is fine. What about Michael? Has he ever done anything weird? can I ask an important question, Jermaine? What's Michael's favourite panel show?
It's not this one.
It's not this one?
And John's teammate this evening is Henning Vane. Henning does have a disadvantage playing Countdown in his second language. Of course, maybe things would be different if his granddad had fought a bit harder.
Feels a bit to me,
yeah,
like Leona Lewis came along and you didn't even put up a fight.
Oh, but the thing is, me and Leona Lewis are two totally different entities.
Of course,
I mean,
of course, you're almost as good as well.
I personally think global warming is a myth, like World War II and women's rights.
No, you did!
A threesome is better in the imagination than in real life.
Is it, though? I might come to the forefront and argue this, because I'm getting slightly put off. Good. Right, not all the weird sexual stuff you hear about is as good as it's cracked up to be. I mean, you can tell me how great auto-asphyxiation is until you're blue in the face. Where are my manners? Let me just explain that to the blondes. What they do is they choke the people and then they return blue. So till you're blue in the face is a phrase that people use. So it's sort of like a joke. Let's move on. Before I have sex with two women, I'm going to, you know, want to experiment a little bit. I want to dip my toe in the water and have sex with one girl. That one. She's got a tattoo there. And I like pictures.
In a little slight situation, I was born in Scotland, my dad lives in Scotland. Hi, Dad.
Go and see him while you're over here, for Christ's sake. You live in LA, you're going to come over here and wave at him on telly and fly back.
That's actually quite correct. But I love him very much and I'll see him next time. But I do think...
I'm sure he'd be thrilled with that little terms and conditions at the end. If you do not keep up the payments, I will never see you again.
Can I carry on?
With your relationship with your dad.
I've got this image of her because she just seems so down to earth, you know, and she's 40-something and she's dressed in this roller skating outfit. I've got this image of all these record producers coming up to her and going, so Kylie, we're doing this new rave thing and it's like this 80s synthesizer and her just going, oh, okay, yeah, all right. And you've got to wear like this futuristic roller skating outfit. Oh, yeah, all right, that sounds fine. How much am I getting paid for this? Oh, $10 million, I'll put that in my savings account. Yeah. I wish I had a baby.
You went to number 10.
I went to number 10 recently and had a cup of tea.
Come on, tell them, what were you doing at number 10? What excitement?
It was with a group of women who were voted Mums of the Year, and David Cameron came along and had a cup of tea with us.
Oh, I wasn't there.
Sorry, Natalie. These were all amazing mums who've done incredible things.
Because it's...
People say the world would be a better place if everybody was naked all the time. A better place for who? Rapists. I'd like to go about dressed as a Viking in my day-to-day life, but I don't do that because I'm aware that that would make me look weird. But who's more likely to get arrested popping out for a pint of milk? Someone dressed as a Viking or someone with their cock out? I've done an experiment and it's both.
I've got a weak stomach, and reading the news on a weak stomach is not good.
No.
My sister once had to throw up. She's a newsreader as well, and she had to throw up in between the stories. So she would do an intro and then go, and then carry on.
Krishnan, would you ever go on Strictly?
I have been asked. It's basically middle-class porn, isn't it? Strictly Come Dancing, as far as I can tell. It's like, it's the job of the female newsreaders to sort of bounce around to entertain the bloke.
Like your sister.
And
well, this is. I don't like to generalise, but most women are pretty good at multitasking. Would you agree with that? You're pretty good at multitasking?
Yeah.
Yeah, so you don't need two women. Just get her to tickle your balls while she works the shaft. Most attractive accent?
I'd like to put myself up for this one.
It's a bad noise to start with.
Is it the mosquito accent?
No, I could probably be American accent, I'd say. When I have sex, I always try to do it in an American accent just to take the edge off this one.
American accent during sex, could you give us an example of some of the things you say? I can't remember.
Well, you have to...
School ruins my sex life. Obviously, I can now only come if I make love in a tiny dark room filled with sports equipment.
I think women sumo should be... Actually, I don't know if it should be on television. I think that you're what webcams were invented for.
Such a... Oh, my God.
No, I think that's a good... You're a lovely-looking fella.
These are all mine. You don't need to worry about that.
All yours?
Everything.
I think you've been slightly greedy.
Oh, that was good! Too much to handle for you.
I wouldn't know where to begin.
'Hands up' all of those who think that Rufus Hound talks bullshit and looks like Rolf, the Nazi boyfriend from The Sound of Music.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Hang on.
What?
Some people behind you are actually putting their hands up.
This is the rudest show I've ever been on. You're a pervert.
Sorry, mate.
What? His name is Rod.
Oh, I'll tell you what. This is how they start. I go, have we or have we not been to the moon? She goes, it's not physically possible to go to the moon as a human. Like, she said the radiation is so thick after you get to 700 miles above the Earth that our skin would fall off.
Well, I think we've got to try it, and I nominate Ollie. Well, because you might not come back. Oh, you're too adorable. Look at that.
And welcome a woman who's brainier than Kurt Cobain's garage wall. It's Carol Vorderman.
Gabby, last time you were on the show, I was hosting. I may have accidentally inferred that you were incredibly boring. You told me about how you'd been to Steve Cram's New Year's Eve party. And since then... No, I learned my lesson then that you were not boring. And since then, I've been looking at your blog. And OMG. LOL. RUFL, your blog is incredible.
I haven't blogged for a long time.
I've had your blogs published. This is Gift of the Gabby.
Gift of the Gabby.
You've got copies down here. I've got copies for all of you as well. Don't worry,
can I see?
Yeah. Have a little look. If you read on the back, it says, a real page turner, Usain Bolt, look, it says on the back. Look at this one. This is brilliant. Your blog for this one was called The Green Drink. Do you remember this one?
You bastard.
What? Can you tell me a bit more about the green drink?
No, you twat.
I had a joint birthday party with someone with less friends than me. I've never felt so high in my life.
John, how did you feel about that?
We're talking about the richest people in Britain, people who make Boris Johnson look like Kerry Katona, which he already does a little. right?
Many he really does, though, doesn't he? Mm.
Pip, pip, what-o.
Dig deep.
For the school honour, come on.
You can do the voice, Jimmy, but I know that you weren't that well-schooled.
I wasn't a professor in Ballamore.
Hold it. Watch this now. Just give me a little time. There it's going. Watch this.
Hang on. Oh.
Oh my arm!
Look, look, look. Wait, wait, wait.
Oh, that is bullshit. Look at mine.
And my shoe came
off. Does everybody say that?
Look at this.
Ah, Jimla.
I can tell you this, that if you people at home, which is my camera,
no,
is that number
camera
two?
Camera two, yeah, camera two. Go on,
you do people at home, honestly, let's take this seriously for 1 minute.
This is one of the biggest benders in the world here. Come on.
Put the spoon on your television set. Let us give him 10 seconds to get a spoon from the kitchen.
Okay, go and get a spoon.
Blaze,
I'll tell you what, I'm slightly magic as well. Look at this, and it's disappeared.
we have to be serious now.
Oh, my God! I've turned into Jason Manford.
I'm just going to change those two back. Go, now.
Everybody at home, place your spoon on your television set. All of us are going to say, 1, 2, 3, go!
Okay,
and your spoons are going to jump off the TV at home.
OK.
But turn the speaker up really loud.
Wait a minute.
OK.
We shout... Go.
Okay,
one, two, three.
Go.
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 Now, if your spoon did jump off, if it sailed across the room, email Jimmy.
Yeah, definitely email me.
Jimmy, are you...
everybody looks awesome with a piercing. Awesome. Awesome. I'm just rolling that word round my mind and trying to get it to fit with what I can see here. To be honest with you, I can't get it to fit. There are words that will fit with what I can see. Words like Christ, stop, and why. But not so much awesome. I'm not going to ask Prince Albert what happened to him during his childhood that made him want to do this thing that he's doing here, because I've got a feeling that the answer might be a little bit a bit gritty, a little bit BAFTA winningly hard-hitting. So, you know, it may be...
He's standing right there.
It may be...
Yeah, that's great. Yeah. Do you float a lot in the ocean?
Sure. What, do you sink? It might be that cast-iron heart.
I'd like you to begin arguing that gays have more fun.
I mean, being gay, it must be fun, otherwise they wouldn't make all that noise.
Miles, what noise do they make, Miles?
You've heard Will Young sing, haven't you? I can only describe it as a fucking noise.
Being gay is not, I imagine, all that much of a laugh.
Otherwise, they wouldn't make all that noise.
I am losing my hair and it really is a pain. I find out every morning when I see the shower drain. But as you can see, it isn't quite for me. But at least I'm not quite as bald as Colin Mockery.
Oh man, took my rhyme. I was gonna do that. I have all my hair and I really am quite happy. I like putting stuff on my hair, it makes me look real snappy.
I love to comb my hair, I never need a breather. I'm real happy, I'm not Colin McRae either. People always kid me cause I'm losing all my hair. I can't really help it that I'm follically impaired. It really is quite horrible, but my life is not through. I still get way more sex than either Brad or Drew.
The Independent describes the Dostoevsky metro station with its depressing murals as the mecca for suicides. Not to be confused with the mecca for suicide bombers, which is Mecca. According to the Times...
What we're looking at here is a vain man. A man so narcissistic that all he really wants to be doing right now is looking in the mirror and playing with himself. The tragedy, ladies and gentlemen, is thanks to the freakishly bulbous nature of his arms and shrunken penis that he cannot reach. Which is actually just as well, because not knowing his own strength, were he ever to grab a handful of penis, he'd wrench it away from the moorings like an angry bear at a sausagey barbecue. Now, you might think I'm being rude, that I'm hurting his feelings, but don't worry, it doesn't understand me.
I'm not aware that David Cameron's...
You're not aware of anything.
No, no, I think it's a bit early for you to start in on me on this show. I don't think there's enough respect for the royal family on this programme.
Songs with Dave Poland.
I really don't.
How can you respect the band of murderers?
I think Wills and Harry have absolutely no interest in marching songs. They like soul songstress Joss Stone and a chap called Farrell. He's a hip-hop master mixer. And according to the Times...
When you said hip-hop.
That's what I meant to do, isn't it? Yeah.
What, hip-hop?
Yeah. According to the Times, Farrell has been collaborating with Britney Spears, Justin Timberlake and Snoop Dogg.
You know they get you to read these out just to make you sound silly. You know that.
The Paris Hilton work was a low point for me. It wasn't what I wanted to be doing. And on top of that, it caused me some real problems with my hair.
Good. Haven't you read it? I don't want to spoil the ending for you.
The photo shoot was for the Daily Mail, which made me feel really posh and upmarket.
Are you kidding me?
What? Sorry. Oh, no, Preston,
no,
come
no,
on.
No, seriously, guy, no.
Preston, we're having fun.
Fine.
Come on, Preston. Oh, no, we can't lose Preston.
I guess he thought he's been voted out.
No. Professor Green, you came to prominence through rap battles, all right? Man After My Own Heart.
Here we go. Is this where the rapping becomes a part
No, I've got a theory, right? You got stabbed last year, right?
Yeah.
What happened?
He was a Muppet.
I have a theory that he stabbed you because you sound like a character in Cluedo. Was it Colonel Mustard?
Look, that was funny.
Are you drawing a lane?
No, I was just saying, you know...
Don't draw a lane in words when you could rap about it.
That was funny and there's no question, but I'm not leaving because I'm not Preston.
Compared to a baby, everyone's quite terrifying. Like, compared to a baby, I'm quite intimidating.
No, not you. Okay, not a good example to pick. You look younger than the royal baby.
Oh, he does. But he's so cute. No, I know, but you're cute. Look at me face. You're so cute. You know what? When you're 90, you'll still look like that. You'd be glad.
didn't come on here to be flirted with by Lorraine.
You need to prepare for this one.
I've been told to ask you, Andy, what's a triple threat, by the way?
Someone who can sing, dance and act and coming for you.
You say threat?
If you,
I wouldn't like to be in a fight with you. You want to fight with me? You'll fight with my mate, Andrew. I can sing, I can dance and I can act. So just back off! I think I'm coming for you is the biggest threat.
Or over you.
Oh, come on. You've let yourself down, you've let this young lady down. You've let,
still
you've let Noel's mum down.
Still
actually,
like
I usually let Noel's mum down. Oh, come on, I'm sorry, Mrs. Fielding.
My mum's in. That's
I know she's
even
in,
funny.
That's what I'm saying. It. Is your dad in?
Yeah, he's next to her.
He's going
to
come and have me singing, dancing, and acting later, isn't he? What did you say about my wife? He's got the chat down, dance!
Woo! I'm going to prove that women should be in sport on television. We have a woman, she does sport, we're on television. Let's fight. Bring it on, we're going to circle. I'm going to fuck you up. I've been playing Street Fighter recently. I've got E. Honda. Come on.
And how many six-foot black women have you dated lately?
What are you doing?
What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? Sean, get her! Sean! Grab her fanny!
I'm ready for this, bro.
Ready for this?
I'm ready. This show gets more and more like the Generation Game. So, yeah, this is the basic slam.
OK, wait.
Hey, whoa!
That's fine, Terry. Thank you, you're no longer the scariest person on the show. Are you OK?
I think
sure?
so.
Seriously.
I've done one lesson, I'm not very good.
And, of course, in charge of numbers is Rachel Riley. With her striking good looks, blonde hair and tight mini dresses, it's safe to say that Rachel's probably killed off more old men than a winter cold snap.
He got Jeremy Hunt's name wrong.
And you've got to be careful on the radio, haven't you, Jonathan?
He switched one letter. He switched one letter. Two.
John phones his mum every single day. Keep on trying, John. One of these days, she's bound to pick up.
You know when you have people around for dinner, is this how you introduce them? Joining me tonight is my friend Steve, who's got a small dick.
Oh, lovely. Okay, I asked you. So, well, you all got that, didn't you? Yes. You, did you get that?
Oh, sorry. What?
I've known you for some time.
Yes.
When
Rob.
Did you develop that stupid laugh?
It's not a stupid laugh. It's a grant. I know when I laugh it sounds a bit like a seal is being molested, but...
What is it? Where did that come from?
My laugh.
Well, I would ditch it and ditch it now. Russell, give him a better laugh. What should his laugh be?
I think it's interesting that you've known him as long as you have and never heard him laugh. I think that's an indictment of you, Rob.
In a horrible way. Horrible, horrible, horrible. I'm being quite serious. It really was. It was horrible, horrible, horrible.
You don't want to roll that R so much when you're serious. It's like you're taking the piss out of him and all.
Well, you can never do it.
I can roll them, I just can't say them normally. I can roll them easy. Horrible, say... horrible, horrible.
That roll sounds them. Like you're trying to cough something out.
Well, at least then I go, ho-ho-ho-ho-ho!
Ho-ho-ho-ho-ho! Who's that?
This show just evolved into noisy.
Hang on, don't review the show while you're on it, Charlie.
Let's just do an hour of farmyard animal noises and all go home.
That's very good.
That's very good. I'm disappointed because when Claudia says, I'm going to do an horse, I perked up. Just for that. Well, hello. My luck's changed.
OK, you all got that
listen
right.
Listen to it was... Jimmy's laugh now. You've pointed out Jimmy's laugh to me.
It's terrible, isn't it? I know. It really breaks.
I didn't notice it before.
Good. OK. Woody Woodpecker's arrived.
We cannot get into a position where none of us feel able to laugh. It's like victimising the audience and taking the piss out of them. We're all sick here in stony silence.
Yeah. No, he's doing it! He's doing it!
It's an expression of joy.
OK, you all got that right. It was...
condoms on a man before you have intercourse?
Do you?
We just cuddle.
Or Kylie Minogue.
Definitely Kylie Minogue.
Do you miss her, Jason?
Deeply.
Yeah. Are you still friends?
Yeah, yeah.
Can Very we do close. A duet?
Do you want to give her a call?
Yeah. Do you really have Kylie's number? And tell me honestly.
No, he doesn't. He's pretending. He's holding on to the par. Let it go. You've got Kerry Katona.
Actually, my wife says, Mrs. Bone says, yes, that whenever my nostrils flare, I'm not telling the truth. That's just what she says, but I don't know whether you can interpret anything into that.
Crikey, it must be hard to control at home.
I'm like a little donkey.
You know, donkeys are phenomenally well endowed. Is this true about yourself? You have a big nose, which is promising.
Fred is a good liar.
Fred is a good liar? Is he why?
He said he was good at boxing.
Just got caught up out of his hands.
For fuck's sake, you're getting abused by a child.
And we heard Daft Punk with Around the World. The song Around the World features the same lyric 143 times. It's even more repetitive than this sound. Hello, Kylie. Please pick up. It's me again. Just call. Please, just call. Just call.
Yes, it's true. One Christmas morning, Richard did wake up stark naked in his shoe cupboard, clutching nothing but two cans of fake snow. Judy was quite pleased when she came across Richard sitting there stark naked, as it reminded her to put the turkey in the oven.
No, I'm not very popular over in Belgium.
Why is that?
I seem to have upset the former Prime Minister. It was just sort of straight talking, really, but they didn't like it very much.
Well, it was more rude. Wasn't it?
Well, I thought it was just normal parliamentary banter, really.
Well, but you said that one of UKIP's promises was that you would restore British things like politeness to debate, and then you called him a damp rag.
Yeah.
And said Belgium was a non-country.
Well, that's true. No, that is true.
Now, you mustn't assume that the general population is as ignorant as you are.
Remember that, then.
Celsius. Well, it makes sense now when you think about when you've been in the hot country and you're tossing at night, you can't get off, and then you hear that... No. I'm simply not having it.
Sounds like it.
After beating Bishop, you are the fastest man in the world.
Listen, Dermot, I cannot possibly say that. All I'm saying is I'm probably one of the fastest men over a metre.
Because you've covered half a metre before I started.
Just imagine you were single. Would you go for Matt Horn? Is he your type?
No.
Yeah, I tell you, he doesn't hate Connie Hart.
Okay, Dara.
She's a good girl.
Hang on.
Don't mess with the hook.
What is that?
Do you fancy her?
He dresses up as Zara Larsson. He dresses up as Zara Larsson.
He winks at you.
Kids TV kind of thing, and I quite like... she's getting dissed at the moment.
Yeah.
I'm just saying she's...
He loves her, he loves her.
No, she
look at him squirm.
Have you ever met her, Dara?
I've never met her. No.
You
like to
clearly
meet her, Dara?
Would you like
to
sidle
now
up to her and say, here's something I made earlier?
Dara, does your wife watch this?
Yeah, but she doesn't watch Blue Peter, so I'm all right. cares, isn't it?
You might as well just shut the door.
Which brings us to my next question, and Nutters. Where exactly is the best place in England to find Nutters?
On one of your documentaries.
Thank you very much.
Education, the answer is 25 in a row. What is the question?
Is it how many times has Dara Brien cracked one off on Blue Peter?
To draw her into a political battle. I'm not going to have an obsession with the woman or something.
In the corner of your room, do you have a wankometer?
Can a man not form an unnatural attachment to someone they've never met on the television without it resorting to masturbation jokes? he's just made a little shrine.
Can I point out, stop writing Dara fancies Connie on a piece of paper.
Jesus. Do you know when you have to make something out of papier-mâché, do you just not need glue?
Is there a possible round on small dicks we could do next? Don't fail, I'm taking enough of a hammer in here.
That's what your girlfriend said.
How long are you engaged for?
Just a year.
See, that already seems quite a long time.
Well, it's not really, because you're trying to plan it and then it schedules and all that stuff. Are you more of a sort of just go to Vegas and get it done type guy?
You make it sound like a tattoo.
It is in some cases.
You're all pretty close. Have any of you been caught out telling any of the other members of the band any lies?
A couple of times, haven't we?
Apparently, Harry told the others he could fucking sing.
Pete Townsend suffers from tinnitus, an annoying, monotonous buzzing. It sounds as if it's coming from the base of your skull. If you want to know what that sounds like, tune in to Chris Evans on radio.
Mackenzie.
It is a piece of medical apparatus used for determining the size of testicles in male humans.
Yeah. Wait a minute.
What?
Some of them are so small, they're tiny.
You'd be surprised.
I haven't been anywhere near any.
Well, don't bring it to me. I don't want to.
Hey, Rob, bring back memories.
Yes. What do TV presenters know about politics?
About as much as politicians know about presenting television shows.
Worms attack silk, so presumably there wasn't enough silk in the dress. They had to keep the silkworms away.
No, you're way off.
No, they couldn't get real
worms.
No,
they make silk. So were there not enough? Sorry, Alex.
Well, you're both wrong, so you needn't worry.
Well, you can give him the courtesy of listening to him.
Why do I want to listen to a wrong answer?
Well, you're in the Tory party most of your life. Tennis has enabled me to achieve things I could never have dreamt of.
Have you seen my girlfriend? Hey.
Do you know what? I feel that maybe our team has had enough abuse, and I feel the need to maybe turn the tables on you.
Yeah.
For a change, and potentially show something a little bit embarrassing about you. Shall we have a look at that?
No.
Yes, let's have a look.
Simon, sorry.
Simon. Sorry.
Simon.
Darling!
Yes! That's what I said. Good morning. For a long time.
even Anne and Nick look embarrassed for me. I was 12 and I had a mortgage to pay and kids to feed. Finally, what do you do when you've got three talented and sexy stars but you need a fourth? You do what Blues management did and call Anthony Costa. It's Anthony Costa!
Lee was rubbish. He had that weird video when he, like, lay in a pool in a suit.
Yeah.
Cheers, Kate.
Yeah.
No, it's true.
Do you still talk to them or you don't bother anymore?
Yeah, I still speak to them.
And what do you say?
Hello.
And who writes that?
That's a good saver. That's a good one.
Every pop star will tell you how off-putting it is to have a giant penis thrown at you when you're performing. During the Blue days, Anthony Costa was thrown at Bryan Adams. Groove Is in the Heart was a huge hit for D-Light, but they struggled to follow it up. But let's not make fun of one-hit wonders, especially when Anthony Costa's here. At least until he's had one.
Who brought out his autobiography, Mac the Life, about a simple northern lad who breaks into showbiz and which has already been described as a cracking read and is available at all good bookshops at the very reasonable price of $18.99? Was it Lee Mac or Fleetwood Mac?
I don't know, but it sounds shit.
Yeah, you wouldn't like it. None of the words rhyme.
I will have a consonant, please.
M.
Another consonant.
B.
I'll have a vowel.
E.
Got one. Oh! That's the closest you'll ever get, Jimmy.
A lot of people forget that under the Drew Carey Show, Ryan and I have been totally naked.
Of course, some of us needed a wide-angle lens.
And some of us needed a Zoom.
Mark, if you had a superpower, what would you choose? What would you go for?
Is overtaking Vettel a superpower?
Just saying.
No, I'm not. I'm not courting at the moment.
A single man.
Yes.
With plans to settle down?
I get why you've got your little sour face on.
Shut up.
Hang on.
Shut up, Alex.
Got it.
Shut up.
You two know, because you said to me...
No, shut up.
Johnny used to go to your sister.
No, shut up. I told you. Shut up.
I've been reading your book on the toilet a little bit as well. And there's a little bit about Johnny in there.
Why are you talking about reading it on the toilet?
Well, it's not quite good enough to take an holiday, mate.
So, when you're ready, Fred, when you're ready, Georgie and Jimmy, we'll hand over to Jonathan. Best of luck, guys. Let's see what sort of time you can do this in.
This will be fine.
Oh, Jesus! Shit.
Georgie, that's the same as the one in your bedside drawer, isn't it?
I think it might be the same one. I think it's the same one.
Hi, Kedden. We've got some famous faces in. Who have we got? We've got Jamila. Jamila, how you doing, Jamila? You all right? It's exciting for me because you present the Radio 1 chart show. You get to tell the nation what is number one every week. And the only way that that could be more exciting, I think, would be if it was 20 years ago when anybody gave a shit.
Quick, next! Come on, I want some points!
You'll get points, Lily.
Okay, just hurry up.
Rhythm is gonna get you, rhythm is gonna get you, rhythm is gonna get you. Gloria Estefan. Thursday, watch The Walls instead.
Come on, move on to the ones I know. Come on, please.
You know what you need?
No! Simon, it's gonna be harder!
Come with me. You need a hug.
Yeah. I know, can't stay in it. Just enjoy the hug. I know you feel you have issues with intimacy. You feel that you're not loved. You have 100,000 friends on MySpace, but are they real friends that you can touch? No, I'm touching you now. Okay?
Okay,
everyone loves you here. You don't need points.
Okay.
You can even just be you.
Okay, thank you.
Match the time up on the phrase.
It's great.
Yeah.
I hurt my lower lumbar. You'll know we'll never get far.
Riding around a stolen police car, following criminals.
Yeah. You're right with that?
Yeah, I'm totally all right with that.
You look so upset.
No, I'm not. I just do something different for a change.
Oh, what?
Like, is it played, like give me my own lyrics
it's
over
okay.
and over.
It's part of the game, Huey. I know. It's like part of the, like...
We're getting points.
People sit on the show and then, like, the way you tie in the factors, it's kind of funny. Oh, look, it's your own lyrics.
I've been on the
forget
show, like, 9 times.
Do you want me to just make it up, then?
Yeah, just pick some shit.
Pick some shit. Get ready for the next episode.
Snoop Dogg.
No, what's the next line? It's next lines, man.
Because we ain't got no love for hoes.
No.
Oh, Lieutenant, I ain't pussy to put my ass up on.
No. Baby, I can make you feel good.
But then someone goes, I can make you feel good. Someone goes, I can make you feel good. So technically that is the line afterwards.
Backing vocals aren't included.
Well, I did not know the rules.
Okay, well, now you know the rules. Can you answer the question?
Someone should have told me
this. Okay, it's Let Me Know This Good of Love, Anya, by I Can Make You Feel Good by Kavanagh.
Are you all right?
Why are you so annoyed about the next line game?
Let's just go on with this.
So angry.
You know,
just
got to sing the next line, yeah? We're not trying to piss you off.
No, you're not upsetting me. It's fine.
Okay.
Kavanagh, man, that's some dangerous
right,
music.
Right, so.
No, I just don't roll like a punk. I'm sorry.
Chewy, it's the game, bro. I say a line, you sing the other line. They were just there on the show. You'd have to smash a mug in my hair. Right, let's carry on. You're upset, I know. Sorry, next time we'll be more offensive.
See me upset.
I know. Don't want to see me when I'm angry. Let's go. I thought you'd go to A&E to do this.
Yeah. Right, so, I can't be bothered. Right, so, Noel's team, you need 5 points to win, but I'd maybe suggest not winning, otherwise... I get a bit cross. Okay, your time starts now. Mama do the hum.
The humpity hum.
No. Close.
Look, what? Look, listen. No! That's enough now, it's enough.
So, in the interest of safety, the final scores are...
Noel's team have 4.
But tonight's winners, well... Tonight's winner is music. No.
I thought,
unlikely things to hear in a restaurant.
Wow, thanks for picking up the bill, Dara.
Oh, yes.
Still, yes. Wait a minute, you called your band UFO.
Hey, listen, I didn't call my band UFO.
Who did call your band UFO, sir?
I bet it was Arishay.
Arishay, to be fair, did come with that name first.
So was it called UFO because in the beginning only really crazy people believed in you?
Anyway, so...
Go on.
No wonder your sausages are so good. Oh, I don't like that bit.
Go on. You've done that before. No.
Unlikely things for Andy Murray to think.
I remember when I used to train.
What is that? He's in the room.
So... I remember when I used to train in Scotland, I was a lot more unhealthier. I used to serve with a potato instead of a ball so I could have lots of chips afterwards.
I wonder if Kim really likes tennis.
Wish Kim had shut up.
Oh, hey, Barney, so funny. Why do I spend my life trying to hit a fuzzy green apple with a snowshoe?
Venus has the arse, Serena's got the tits.
That's not going in.
Begging thing.
It's a begging thing.
Do you know what? You'd be quite happy at home on the streets.
Yeah.
But then again, not many people would take that pee on you. Because you're pretty ugly.
Ooh! I should explain. Bill is a professional comedian. You won't win. I would pass it over at this point. But Donny Tourette has gone missing.
Mid-show, the boy has disappeared. Who knows where he's gone?
I will pass it over, but I'll play him.
I'm sound, yeah.
Good, good.
That's what I think of you.
Really?
Why
you think me a small penis?
Well, I never...
I will voluntarily give you my points.
All right.
They're all in Bitcoin. They're worth nothing.
And now... I'm sorry, was that Bitchcoin?
Shove some pasta in her mouth. Shove some pasta in her mouth.
The answer is 1,000,000%. What is the question?
Is it, what is the blood alcohol content of Amy Winehouse?
Is it, after a recent power surge, what did Stephen Hawking say over and over again for 3 days? Is it, what increase in population will Kerry Katona be responsible for? The time her womb finally succumbs to the ravages of time and chicken drumsticks.
I've missed you, Frankie.
The next topic is unnerving things to hear during a medical examination.
You have the body of someone half your age growing inside your womb.
You're unlikely to hear on a quiz show.
Hello and welcome to Ask the Family. Mr. Fritzel, where's the rest of them? I'm Anne Robinson, and if my Botox wears off, my face will turn into a scrotum. I'm Richard Whiteley.
Things that would change the atmosphere at a dinner party.
Ignore the banging. She's been in there for 24 years.
Well, this is absolutely lovely. I say we all raise a glass to the Führer!
Is it a bird? Is it a plane? Whatever it is, it's heading straight for the World Trade Center. What's that, Joker? You'll be back. Somehow, I don't think you will be.
Max Mosey doesn't do Nazi-themed orgies, but if he did, they'd probably be the best...
Things you wouldn't hear on Songs of Praise.
Hello, Canterbury, let's make some fucking noise! And we appear to have a streaker. No, one of the altar boys has escaped from the vestry.
Christians in one corner, Muslims in the other, let's get ready to rumble!
Lines you wouldn't hear in a war film.
I can't feel my legs! That's because your arms have been blown off.
Rejected from this year's exams.
By the year 2015, the population of the Earth will have increased by 20%. How do we find Kerry Katona and stop her? If an object is travelling at 750 miles an hour, encounters resistance and slows to zero, for how many months will Richard Hammond have to wear nappies?
On the diagram below, show on the body where you like to be touched.
Describe Uranus without telling your parents.
Amy is 16. At least she said she was.